Hello, my name is David Schaad, and I'm a professor of the practice and associate chair in the Department of Civil and Environmental Engineering here at Duke University. And I want to talk to you about clean water, actually water quality, and one unit process today called reverse osmosis. So when we think about water quality and flushing toilets and drinking the water that we do, we realize that engineers save lives and make human civilization possible. It was just over 150 years ago that in the U.S., people were dying of diarrheal illnesses. Understanding germ theory and public health disease outbreaks was something that we hadn't understood quite yet. So we have eradicated diarrheal illnesses and waterborne diseases in the United States for the most part, but that isn't true globally. When we think about the global disease burden associated with waterborne illnesses, over a billion people lack access to improved water quality supplies, and 2 billion lack access to improved sanitation. So let's put that in context. How many is a billion? How many is a million? So let's talk about a million seconds. How long is a million seconds? So if we do the math, million seconds, it's a little under 12 days. So we could do anything for 12 days, right? We could even sleep outside for a basketball game. How long is a billion seconds? So let's do the math again. It's over 30 years. When we think about the disease burden between a million and a billion people is three times the population of the United States that don't have access to clean drinking water supplies. The numbers are staggering. And it's 2 billion that don't have access to potable improve sanitation. So engineers bring the tools of scientific discovery to treat these issues of clean drinking water. So when we think about drinking water, we think about the way contaminants distribute in the environment. We talk about really two terms, advection and dispersion. So advection is the principle where, like when you stir a coffee cup, we introduce turbulence, we have velocity, and we have motion. Dispersion is when you drop a contaminant in and it just disperses into the environment. So I'm going to show you a little example. So when we think about dispersion, we're going to let this blue dye disperse into this glass of water. And then this glass, we're going to use advection. Same number of droplets, but this time we're going to stir it up, and we can see that the makes it much easier to get the blue dye through the entire glass. But at the end of this, once this one finally disperses, the same amount of glass will be blue. So to understand dispersion, let's not talk about water, but let's talk about our lungs. Every minute we take multiple breaths. We breathe in air, which has 21% oxygen. That oxygen diffuses across the membrane of our lungs into our bloodstream. And then that blood is pumped to the various parts of our body. The cellular membranes respire carbon dioxide that comes back to our lungs. Carbon dioxide goes into our lungs, and then we exhale carbon dioxide. This diffusion process is one of the ways that we use to treat water. And so what ends up happening is we use a process called reverse osmosis. So again, just like these glasses, water concentration wants to move from areas of high concentration to low concentration. It wants to equilibrate throughout the entire process. So if we have, just like in our lungs, we have high concentration of oxygen, low concentration of oxygen, the oxygen diffuses across the membrane of our lungs. The same thing is true if we have salt water or other water that's got more solute on one side than the other. So what's going to end up happening is if we have two containers, equal amounts of water, but one with more salt in it, what will end up happening is by osmosis, the water will be drawn from the glass that has less salt over to the side that has more salt to dilute the side that has more salt. And the water level will actually rise on this side of the glass. That's the process of osmosis. Maybe your parents talked to you about understanding things by osmosis. Well, it actually does happen. The osmotic pressure draws the water across that membrane. And so what we do as a treatment process, a unit process for treating water, is we actually reverse that process. We'll induce a high pressure on one side of the glass, which will drive the fresh water across that membrane, keeping back the reject water or the brine solution on this side of the membrane. And then, of course, we can find a useful use for that, but then this side is clean water. And this is important in lots of different applications. For drinking, obviously, but for high-tech manufacturing, for desalination, for lots of different future uses that we're going to need as humanity. So water quality is really, really important as we think about, again, engineers save lives and enable human civilization. Water quality is going to continue to be a bigger and bigger issue as we continue to grow in terms of population and as we are in or already living in areas where water quality is scarce. How are we going to address humanity's future water needs? Thanks for watching. I hope you learned something. Appreciate your time.